There's just something about drinking from this cup.
Yes. Yo, what's up, guys? Welcome back. Thank you so much for tuning in, and I really appreciate you guys take your time and tuning to my YouTube channel. So I'm back again with another iPhone 11 Pro Max video, and this is gonna be my first review. Basically, I'm gonna be sharing with you the experiences that I've actually had with the phone since I got it the past 2-3 days. So I still have the device here with me, and I must say the improvement or the experience that I'm getting, it's actually amazing. Based on the fact that I've been on iPhone XR, so jumping from this to this is actually a significant jump, and I must say I'm thrilled. I'm actually tempted to switch into this as my daily driver, but it's just a thought at the moment. Anyway, let's jump into it and let me tell you more about my experience. This review will be based basically more on how I actually interacted with the phone compared with the current phone that I'm using as my daily driver, which is the iPhone XR. So the response on this phone, it's actually amazing. Looking at the screen, the refresh rate is actually higher, but basically, of course, you know that this runs an OLED display and that one has an LCD, but however, that's a Retina display, and then this is a Super Retina XDR display, which I don't know. It has a huge impact where response is concerned, and I actually like how you can actually maximize the screen to actually watch the videos on it, and I can actually tell you about the difference compared to watching a video on that one. So what I basically did, I shoot a video on this iPhone 11 Pro Max, and then actually transfer it to the iPhone XR, and then I viewed the same video on both the device. And I could tell you, wow, the different ones, just amazing. It's just the challenges on the YouTube app, you are not able to watch a 4K video on your smart device. So what you can do, I think you can use Chrome. So if you use Chrome to watch a 4K video on YouTube, that's when you are able to do that. So that's basically what I did. But if I shoot a video on 4K here and then actually transfer there, that's basically the comparison. So if I use like a camera to shoot a 4K video and bring it here, and share it with the iPhone XR as well as the XS. The difference I can actually tell as to this phone actually has better display than the rest of the phone. And I know that most people are kind of like disappointed that the screen doesn't have 3D touch, and now we are making use of haptic touch, and which for me is really not much of a difference or a concern, based on the fact that I'm still able to use the phone. I'm still able to do my highlights on the text and all those kind of things. I'm still able to do most of the things that I was doing, because I know haptic touch is kind of like a little bit slower, but I think there's a room for Apple to improve that. I believe when the iPhone 12 or the next generation of iPhone comes, it's gonna have like a better response where 3D touch or haptic touch is concerned, and I really can't complain where that is concerned. So I have here, this is iPhone XS, and then this is what I actually switched from when I go to the XR due to space, and then my fiance basically took over this phone, and I get to use it every now and then to actually test. But there is much of a difference, well, a little bit of a difference between the two. Basically, of course, this is supposed to be compared with the iPhone 11 Pro, and then this is supposed to be compared with iPhone XS Max, which I don't have either of those devices, but this is what I have. And I'm doing comparison between these three phones, which I don't know, the results you can tell if really you're looking into details of each and every feature. So that's pretty much interesting. So going back into the 3D touch, which is no longer there on this phone, is because Apple took it out, and then they increased the battery capacity. So now it's almost like at 4,000 milliamps, I think 3,986, somewhere there, which makes this way better where battery is concerned. So this battery lasts longer than the iPhone XS Max by 5 hours, and then the iPhone 11 Pro lasts 4 hours longer than iPhone XS, which is this device here. And then the iPhone 11 itself, it lasts 1 hour longer than iPhone XR, which is pretty much impressive. And then when it comes to the charging of the battery, actually tried to do the test where I let the phone battery go down. It didn't actually die, but it was at 2%. And then I get to use that 18 watt charging brick, which is this one, and then using that USB-C to Lightning connector, which is, you know, of course the phone still has the Lightning connector, to charge the phone. And I got from 2% to about 50%. So this took me 35 minutes. And I would like to say, so Apple said it will take you 30 minutes to charge to 50%. So it took me 35 minutes to get to 50% charge. So I actually sat down to ask myself, like, I don't know, is it maybe special case or something, that kind of a thing? And I realized, well, during the time I was charging the phone, there were notifications that constantly keep on popping. Instagram, YouTube, WhatsApp, all those things were popping up as I was busy charging the phone. So I believe those items, they actually, like, I don't know, play a role where battery charging was concerned. And I believe that Apple is not so wrong, or it's not far from it, where getting the phone to 50% charge is concerned. So it's really not much of a problem. So one thing that I couldn't get to test was wireless charging. I don't have a wireless charger or any device that support reverse charging that I was going to use to actually charge this phone. But I believe, well, it might get us some decent speed where charging is concerned. I believe it also will depend on the charger itself that you're using to charge the phone. And another thing is, if you're using the cable that comes with the phone to charge from the MacBook Pro that has Thunderbolt port, you are still able to get close to what this 18 watt charge brick can offer. So I actually tested that, and I'm getting something relatively close, because I can get like 50% charge in about 40 minutes 40 45, somewhere there, which is, I don't know, it's pretty much good. If you don't have a brick, you can still have the cable with you, and then you can connect to your MacBook Thunderbolt ports to actually charge the device. And then as to how long it takes to get the battery charge, in my case, like I said, I still had this notification, so it took me like about 1 hour 20 something minutes, I think about 1 hour 21 minutes, to get the whole phone fully charged to 100%, which I believe maybe it can be less than that if the phone doesn't have anything else, or if the phone is actually off. I believe you can get the phone fully charged in maybe less than an hour, or just about an hour or so. But I'm very impressed with how long the battery lasts. So I last charged this device yesterday, and now I'm sitting at about 52% battery remaining, which is, I don't know, it's good, considering that I've tried so much to consume the power on this phone, and it's just, you know, it's holding up. It's something that you can rely on to work with throughout the whole day. And another thing, main feature that we see here is the camera. So I went out to actually test the camera. I didn't actually have enough time to do that, and I didn't get enough time to go to different places where I can take different shots and stuff. But I took a couple of pictures, and then I tested 4K video, and then also take slow feeds. I did time lapse as well as slow motion on the main camera, which was pretty impressive, I would say, considering my condition. The sun was too much and the light was just too much. But the test is good, the quality is very good. I'm just gonna see how it looks when you take it to the computer, or when I take it out exporting for editing. But the reliability of the camera, the response, the quality, and the texture of the items that you are shooting, it's just there with you. And you're able to do to use each and individual camera at one point in time. Like, for example, you can use the wide lens, the ultra wide, and then you can also use the normal telephoto lens to actually tweak a decent photo. So the camera, it's interesting, especially looking at the fact that now we can do 4K video using the front facing camera that has 12 megapixel. You can do that 4K at 60 frames per second. That was impressive for me, because I don't know, I kind of like, I'm still a fan of taking mobile video, like mobile videos, and using the highest resolution available. So I think this will come in handy, so that I get to know and see if I'm on focus or out of focus. For me, it's a game changer. I'm thinking of getting maybe two of this device and do like a proper video fully using this device, and I will leave it to you guys to actually judge. And then coming back to how it looks on the outside, and you can still see that the gap year where the Apple logo was moved from up here to down here. For me, not that it's an issue, but I still have that thing when I'm looking, holding my phone like this, you know? You know, seeing this, can you see the difference? So I still want to see the logo. When I look at my phone at the back, I don't know. It's just that one thing that says, my man, you're holding an Apple. So this part, I don't know, my hand gets to cover it. I can imagine if I get the normal iPhone 11. So definitely, the moment I put my hand on the phone, it will be fully covered. But it's really not much of an issue because, I don't know, it's just a logo. Anyway, I'll get used to it. And then let's go back and look into the iOS that's running here. So this one, like I said on my previous video, this has like iOS 13.1.2. That's what I just recently upgraded to. And the response is good. And this one is running the same, but it's still on the beta profile. I can change it and then put it normally without going through the beta stage. So being on a beta stage, it's basically mean that you're able to test features before they are fully approved for the public use. So basically this is what's happening on this device. And then this one here is still on 12.4, somewhere 12.4.1, I think, if I'm not mistaken. This is the iPhone XS. And both the phone, they still work the same. And then looking at the storage inside, I'm not really much concerned about the storage. I have 256, and I'm not sure if I'll be able to fill it up with the 4K videos, but however, I don't intend to store much here. I'll just shoot and then export to my Mac, edit, and then delete if I don't need to use that footage and feature. And then as well as the RAM, well, now that phone over there has 3 gig, this one has a 4 gig RAM. And then I'm looking at the combination of having 4 gig RAM and then 818 Bionic chip. I don't know, that's for me at the moment where iPhone is concerned, where the speed is concerned. The refresh rate, it's just great. The response of the phone is great. You get to see and feel when you jump from one application to the other, and then when you switch into, especially on the application that don't require internet, sometimes you can be delayed because your application is still waiting to get the connection into the internet. And if your internet is low, then it also plays roles where that application is concerned, or the response of the application is concerned. For example, I don't have faster internet. I have a 10 meg line that gets throttled the moment I use beyond 10, I think 200 gigs. So yeah, so I'll get down to 4, and then from then I'll get down to 2 meg. So I won't get that full experience on the phone, on the application that requires the internet. But nonetheless, there's still a lot of things that one can appreciate in this phone. So I'm not sure what else you guys want to see on this phone. I'll definitely show you the videos that I took on the phone, the pictures, portrait, as well as the new features called the night mode, where you're able to take the photo in the dark and you get fully exposed in light, as if like there's a natural light out there. So that's it for this video, guys. Thank you so much for tuning in, and I'll definitely see you guys.